Okay, shall we start? Good morning. Thanks for showing up and welcome to this presentation on FIWARE Lab and its monitoring system. Let me first of all mention the authors of this presentation. My name is Silvio Cretti. I'm working for CreateNet, a research center located in Italy. The other co-authors that are not present here today, it's Fernando and Pablo from Telefonica Spain and Miguel from Universidad Politecnica de Madrid. Before starting, let me ask you if you are already familiar with FIWARE or FIWARE Lab or not. And so on, please. No one. Wow. Ah, okay. Perfect. So probably it appears that what I'm going to tell you, it's quite new for you. If it is also interesting, I do not know. Let's see at the end of the presentation. You will tell me. Okay, this is the agenda of the presentation, or better, what is in the agenda and what is not in the agenda. Of course, I will start with a quick introduction on FIWARE. Then we will move to FIWARE Lab, its architecture, and the monitoring system, starting from requirement to architecture, and then the issues we found and the solution we put in place. At the end, I will show you a brief demo regarding FIWARE Lab and its monitoring system. What is not in the agenda? Despite we used tools from the OpenStack community like Ceilometer, Ceilosca, and Monasca, this is not a presentation about those tools. So I assume that you are at least a bit familiar with those tools. Okay, what is FIWARE? I'm giving you now an official definition that unfortunately, I'm sorry, it's a bit, contains some buzzwords, and then a more practical one, some example that I think is more understandable. Okay, FIWARE in a nutshell is basically an OpenStack cloud, plus a set of libraries, building software building block, Lego bricks, call them as you want, that expose API in order to help the development of smart, innovative, context-aware, and in particular, data-intensive application. The idea behind FIWARE is to create an ecosystem for innovation, helping the developer, the SME, the entrepreneurs to basically materialize their idea into application and make business out of them. There are five pillars that sustain FIWARE. The first one is FIWARE itself, this set of components, software components that cover general purposes functions in different domains. Here on the right, you see some of them, tourism, transport, smart energy, health, but also smart cities, for example. Of course, having a technology is a new technology, as in this case, is not enough. You need also to provide a playground where this technology should be experimented and tested. And this is exactly what FIWARE Lab is. FIWARE Lab, because it is the focus of this presentation, will be, detailed later on. So I go on now. Having a playground and a new technology is not yet enough if you have a new technology and you want it to be adopted by a broader developers and SME, etc. You need a program that fund the adoption of this technology, that put on the table some incentives to the adoption of this technology. And this is what FIWARE Accelerate is. FIWARE Mundus is a bit different. The idea here is to spread FIWARE all around the world. For example, last October, I have been in Toronto, Canada, in order to discuss a partnership with a Canadian institution there about FIWARE. But there are also partnerships here in the United States, as far as I know, related with US Ignite, Genie, and GCTC, that is the Global City Team Challenge. Last but not least, IABS that provides local and regional FIWARE support. Okay, If you ever came across FIWARE, probably you heard about these generic enablers. What are they? Are the building block, the Lego bricks I mentioned before, that cover this general purpose functionality and offer API for the developers. They are based on an open specification, and of course, given the open specification, you need also a reference implementation, first of all, but then also maybe other implementation. All this, the specification, the generic enable reference implementation, the implementation, the documentation, et cetera, is present in the FIWARE catalog. In the last slides of my presentation, there is a reference, the link to the FIWARE catalog, if someone is interested. Okay. Generic enablers cover different aspects of the technology and are grouped into chapters. We go from cloud computing, where, by the way, OpenStack is, to data and context management, IoT services, advanced web UI, and so on and so forth. All these create a so-called reference architecture in FIWARE. I don't want to worry you about this picture that is quite crowded, but here, let me just comment a couple of things. The boxes are generic enablers, and here the idea is that at the bottom of this picture, there is the so-called data sources, IoT sensor, but not only, also open data, for example. These sources provide data that are collected into the system through IoT gateway, CCAN for open data, et cetera. And in the central part of this picture, you have basically the data dispatching, data analyzing, data processing, and so on and so forth. At the top of the picture, you have the presentation layer, so all the portals, et cetera, et cetera. This could be an example of an architecture of a platform that is based on FIWARE, in this case for a smart city. Okay, I think that I said even too much about the FIWARE. Let's move now to the core of this presentation, that is FIWARE Lab. Okay, as we said, FIWARE Lab is basically the playground for FIWARE, offered to experimenters, to developers, to SME, in order to experiment their innovative application. Also, in this case, I'm giving two definitions, one more official, and another one more practical, more concrete. Okay, FIWARE Lab is basically a working instance of a FIWARE where innovation takes place. And we have different stakeholders that play a role in FIWARE Lab. On the left, we have infrastructure owners, are the ones that provide resources to the FIWARE Lab. Bear in mind these owners because it's quite peculiar to FIWARE Lab. We don't have an owner, but many owners. We will come back on this point later on because it affects the monitoring system. Then we have data providers, as we said, that provides data. On the right, we have, of course, the developers that want to use FIWARE Lab and all the resources for experimentation. And then at the bottom, of course, we have the FIWARE technology providers that are the ones that implement generic enablers, specific enablers, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, this is a more concrete picture of what FIWARE Lab is. It is, a cloud infrastructure based on OpenStack. It is a multi-region cloud distributed all around Europe, but also in Latin America. We have a node in Mexico and another one in Brazil. And it's a public cloud. It is offered for free. It is open and offered for free for experimenters, for developers to play with it. Almost everyone could use it. Of course, there are some rules, but more or less it is free. Each region depicted in this picture is governed, is owned and managed by a different institution. And this, as I said before, creates some specificity around FIWARE Lab. Then, of course, regions are federated in some way. There are some common rules, let me say a common identity structure at the end, IDM, but generally speaking, the resources are quite independent. They offer, of course, cloud resources in terms of CPU, RAM, disk, virtualization, etc., but offer also other type of resources focused on the experimentation of a smart application. And you see a list here on the left, a wireless access network, sensor network, open data, and so on and so forth. So regarding the numbers, the figures of FIWARE Lab, first of all, it is already funded by European Commission. We have at the moment 12 regions with around 3,000 cores, 10 terabytes of RAM, and 600 terabytes of hard disk. More or less 1,500 users and the same number of virtual machines. Is it a big OpenStack multi-region cloud? Well, I would say no, but comparing with the last survey for the OpenStack from the OpenStack Foundation, we can see that it is neither a small cloud. Basically, the position as far as different parameters of a FIWARE Lab is concerned, it's basically in this sector, in the blue light sector, and because we have, for example, if we consider cores, we have more than 1,000 cores. If we consider instance the same. And so at the end, we are positioning FIWARE Lab in the top 30% of the infrastructure that at the moment are using FIWARE Lab, are using OpenStack. The same is true for these two parameters that are the users and the compute node. So having this beast to operate needs a set of tools. I already mentioned a peculiarity of FIWARE Lab, that is the fact that to have different owner managing the different regions. But we have also, due to this, we have also another specificity of FIWARE Lab. And this is related with the fact that it is not a static infrastructure, but is quite dynamic. I mean, regions are joining FIWARE Lab and are leaving FIWARE Lab in a quite frequently at the end. And this is exactly because they are owned by different infrastructure owners that could have many reasons to join, maybe for new funding or to leave FIWARE Lab, maybe because the funding is is finished. So we developed the tools for, of course, joining the FIWARE Lab Federation in terms of deploying a new node, and we based this deployment on OpenStack Fuel. But we did also some customization on this, and we contributed back to the community regarding this customization. Then, of course, this is not enough, and we need a process to join and to leave the federation. And for this, we developed tools for federation management, of course, tools for monitoring that I will leave for the third part of this presentation, connectivity management. The region should be connected among the others. And here we leverage a service, a multi-domain VPN offered by Giant, that is a backbone network in Europe offering a broadband connection to all the academic and research institutions in Europe. And last but not least, We of course, have also to put some services above the infrastructure as a service layer. And for this, we develop a tool for deploying generic enable, specific enable, and other future internet facilities. Okay, just to recap, before moving to the monitoring of FIWARE Lab. This is the high-level architecture of FIWARE Lab. We have many regions. We call them slave regions. where OpenStack is installed with the canonical standard components, but we don't have Kingston, for example, in the remote regions. As opposite, in the master region, in the central region, we have, of course, OpenStack again installed with Kingston, Horizon, and also Monasca. The fact that Kingston has been installed only in the central region creates a lot of problem in FIWARE Lab. I don't want to discuss this now because it's totally another story, but yeah, it creates a lot of problem in the past. This picture allows me to introduce the monitoring now of FIWARE Lab, because as you can see here, we have a Ceilometer installed on each region, but on the master region, we have installed also Monasca. So, okay, monitoring FIWARE Lab. Okay, let's start with the requirements. As said, we had some peculiarity of FIWARE Lab, and these peculiarities derive from the different owners that are playing a role in FIWARE Lab. It is not a centralized infrastructure, it is a decentralized one in terms of government of the entire FIWARE Lab. So this means that as far as monitoring is concerned, every infrastructure owner could have different requirements in terms of monitoring, different needs, different objectives. Just to give you an example, it could happen that an infrastructure owner doesn't want to expose all the data collected on his region to the central region, for example, or wants to collect different metrics with respect to the other region, and so on and so forth. Here then, multi-tenancy is a must. Multi-tenancy is not related with the end users, but multi-tenancy in this case related with the infrastructure owner, the administrator. The second and the third requirement are a classical requirement for any cloud infrastructure. So basically, of course, we need fault management, and we need it under different perspective, the one of the administrator, infrastructure owner, but also the one of the end user, that is, of course, interested to verify that all the end user functionality are working well. A root cause analysis is nice to have in this case. Performance management, the same. We have to keep under control the resource consumption of our resources, the capacity, trend analysis, what if analysis. And in order to do that, we probably need to introduce some analytics techniques, complex event processing, map reduce, and so on and so forth. The last requirement is again specific of a FIWARE Lab, I will say, and is related with the first one. Because we have different infrastructure owner, we could have also different pre-existing monitoring system, different collectors in some way, and we should integrate them into the big picture of the architecture. Of course, Ceilometer is a must, but we don't know what is the rest of data collectors. Okay, this is a picture of the high-level architecture of this monitoring system we deployed. As said, we have the different regions, each one with Monasca agent, Ceilometer, and Ceilosca. We will go a bit deeper into the detail here in the next slides. Then through the MD VPN I mentioned before, we provide data from the remote regions to the central one, where Monasca is installed, and of course Monasca API. Here I didn't sketch the entire architecture of Monasca, but just the main building blocks. Of course, through Monasca API, the data is passed to the Kafka queue and then to the metric database. In this case, we have InfluxDB. But also towards other tools, components, like in this case, big data analysis analytics based on Hadoop. In particular, with the objective to eat our own dog food. We used a generic neighbor here that is called Cosmos, that implements basically, it's based upon Hadoop. On the left part of this picture, we have this box called the FIHealth. What is this? You have to think about something similar to Tempest. We need to measure basically the end user functionality. If everything works well in terms of creating a virtual machine, I don't know, associating a network, an IP address, creating a volume, et cetera, et cetera. And this is what we developed in order to monitoring all this functionality. The data collected by this, this test, this continuous integration at the end test is sent to the Monasca API again and then stored into the database in order to have a complete picture of the entire FIWARE Lab monitoring. And finally, of course, top left of this picture, we have the infographics, so all the presentation layer and the graphical user interface. Going a bit more into the detail of the different regions, as I said, we have, of course, we have controller and compute nodes, but we have here the Monasca agent installed. You could ask why. Well, because of the monitoring of specific processes and services, but also because of the integration, the needed integration, as I said before, with pre-existing monitoring system. So if there were some pre-existing monitoring system through Monasca API, we can send the data to the Monasca, through the Monasca agent, we can send the data to the Monasca API. Okay, then another point here on the remote regions. We have Ceilometer installed, as I said before, and we have Ceilosca. Ceilosca is used to get the data from Ceilometer and send them to the Monasca API. But we have something more in this picture here. We have a couple, in this case a couple, but there are more. Polster, we developed a custom polster of a Ceilometer we developed in order to collect data from different sources not covered by the default Ceilometer data collection. Okay, all this is what we did at an architectural level. Then, of course, we deployed this, this system into production, into FIWARE Lab. I will say that everything went well. Doing this, we had some little problem in the installation of Monasca, but we solved it. What instead I would like to discuss a bit here is a couple of issues we found. Of course, it is not rocket science. There could be probably other way to solve this issue, but I will present here what we did. Again, For the requirement I mentioned before in FIWARE Lab, we had to customize a bit the data collection and in general the information we were collecting by the different region, et cetera. And we found a problem in Ceilosca here because Ceilosca basically assumes that in the metadata section of a given metric, the data is formatted in a key value list, and the value part of this key value should be a string. In some cases, we didn't have a string, like in the example here. We had, again, another key value list, as here in this slide. And this caused a string deserialization error in Ceilosca. Okay, here the solution was quite simple. We just marshaled the value meta before sending it to the Monasca API and this solved the problem. I have a reference if you are interested to the code we developed for this in the last slide. This is, I think, a bit more important. Always regarding Ceilosca, there is a configuration file, Monasca field definition .yaml, that provides some flexibility in handling dimensions and metadata. But it doesn't provide any flexibility in filtering the metrics. Remember that we need to be able to filter the metrics that from Ceilometer, from the remote region, should be transferred, should be sent to the central region. And for this reason, we solved this problem developing a new storage driver in Ceilosca, implant Monasca filter, and of course changing the corresponding configuration file of Ceilosca, adding a new item, metric ID, and under that item, we put a sort of white list of all the metrics that should be sent to the Monasca API. Okay, this more or less, it's the last slide of my presentation, then I have a short demo. So that is what we did. We have a lot of work to do again because we would like to integrate some more powerful analytics with Apache Spark. We should consider open source dashboard like Grafana. Root cause analysis, as I said, is a nice to have functionality. The monitoring of the logging, we are missing this. It's quite important to add this. And because of our experience in Fuel, we would like to customize a bit it in order to automatically deploy our custom pollster agents, et cetera, et cetera. Last but not least, verify if it is possible to contribute back to the community with our software, the software we have developed. Okay, this is the references. The first one is the one to the catalog, the FIWARE catalog, where you can find all the generic enablers. The second and the third is basically the code we developed in order to adapt Ceilosca, Monasca, and Ceilometer to our specific needs. Okay, I have a quick demo now, if it is working, just to show you that FIWARE Lab really exists and it is not just something on the paper. Okay, I don't know if you can see this. Okay, here what I'm showing you now is the infographics, basically the main page of the infographic of FIWARE Lab. You can see here the number of users. Community user and trial user are the one you have to look at. And here we have FIWARE Lab. For example, here you can see that is a live demo because there are two regions here that are gray. That means that are not sending data from couple of hours ago, more or less. Here we have the capacity at the moment of FIWARE Lab in terms of core, RAM, disk, public IP, et cetera, et cetera. We have 12 regions, as I said. Here are the institutions that at the moment are running FIWARE Lab. This is exactly what I said before, many, many different owners that could create some problems. And here, if I go on a given node, I see the capacity of that node. Or, for example, if I click on the cores here, I could see that Spain node is the biggest one, and I can see the total core in Spain node, the virtual, the available, and the one that are used. What I would like also to show you here is that this is the Spain node. So here we have an overview of the cores, the RAM used, and the disk. Here, let me come back to this later on. Here is the calendar, basically, that express the status of the sanity check. The sanity check is the result of the FI health component I showed you before. It's the one that measures the end user functionalities. And here, for example, we have all the list of the compute node in Spain with the measure about the CPU, RAM, disk, et cetera, et cetera. What I wanted to show you again is the sanity check, because I think it's a bit specific of FIWARE Lab. In just a moment. Okay, we have another view here that is based on the status of the different nodes. You can see, for example, two nodes are gray. That means that there are no measures at the moment from these two regions. And one, Sofia Nicoli, has some problem in the sanity check. What does it mean, the sanity check? The sanity check is exactly the measure, the check of the user functionality that are also reported here, averaged basically and aggregated per region and per month. But if I go here, this is a quite simple interface, but I want to show you this because for each region, you see the one that passed the test and the one that are not passed the test. For example, we saw that Sofia Antipoli is red, and we can check why. This is the test list executed every few hours. And in this case, for example, you can see that these three tests, deploying instance, for example, with new network and key pair failed, and you here can see why it fails. So this is more or less what I wanted to show you. Another view is this one, if it is working. Okay, here we see the data in a different way. In this first, these are all widgets provided by generic enablers, FIWARE generic enable. Here you see the data aggregated by region. Here again, the hosts, the virtual machines, and this is another view about flavors, because many problems that are not related with the monitoring FIWARE Lab is to, for example, maintain synchronized and aligned all the federation, given different owners, et cetera, in terms of flavors, images, and so on and so forth. Okay, I think this should complete the presentation. I don't know if there are any questions.
Network monitoring. I didn't see much about that.
Yeah, yes, of course, we have also monitoring about the network, et cetera. Here, I will say, different monitoring system has been used on different nodes, from NAGES to other system. I didn't show this in the demo, but yeah, this is also present in the monitoring system.
Does that flow out of Ceilometer back into
Monasca? It depends. It depends. In some cases, goes from Ceilometer to Monasca through Siloska. But in other cases, given this peculiarity, we use the Monasca agent in order to integrate the different monitoring system, for example, NAGES plugin. And from Monasca agent, we directly send the data to the Monasca API. So we have basically two different types of sources of data to handle. And at the end, everything goes in any case to the InfluxDB into Monasca. Yeah. Any other question? Okay, thank you.